You are now watching Blender Daily Tips and Tricks, and in this video we are going to see how we can make an architectural column using easy steps. So firstly, we are here in the center and we will add a circle. This circle will have 24 vertices and radius of 0.4, and after that we will hit the period, and again we will go to the edit mode and we can extrude it in the Z axis around 1.2. So after that we will make two loop cuts and extrude them in the axis such as this, and let's select this top portion, and we can first hit Ctrl R and add some loop cuts here. So we can select this top part and go to the proportion editing with smooth, and we can now rotate in the axis such as this. So I will rotate in the axis around 95 or 90 and go to the face, and let's select one by one from this portion to this portion. So we will select C and go all the way like this, and we can select this one also, and let's select 2x2. So we'll select two rows and skip two rows. So let's get started. So now we have selected all these faces, and this is the faces that we want to extrude. So we'll in the top view and shift S cursor to selected, and move cursor here to pivot point to be the CD cursor, and we'll extrude scale shift Z 0.88. And again we have this. If you have the time, you can or make all these sharp edges, and you must add loop cuts here, and you must add loop cuts here, and you must do the same for all these parts. After that you can go to the modifiers and add an array modifier, and you must say that it will be in the z-axis by 1, and merge, let's say it will be 4 like this. And again we can make something, we can select this and move in the axis after disabling the proportion editing such as this, or we can, let's move in the axis and rotate in the median point by rotate in the Z to make this to be straight. So we are now done, but we want to add subdivision surface, and again we can now go to shade smooth, and we want to add the top part and the bottom part. So we will apply the array modifier, don't apply the subdivision surface, and we can go here and extrude this to be here, and extrude scale shift Z multiple times, and we will add two loop cuts here. In these two loop cuts we will say that each one will have some thickness, so we will select both, and again we will make some thickness and extrude scale shift Z, and for the bottom part we'll make a selection of this edge, and again we'll extrude in the axis and the scale shift Z. Again we can make the base, and now we have this base. So now we are done for this tutorial, but you can add some details if you have the time. You can extrude the scale and you can make some indentation such as this. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you have the time also, you can make an array of temple such as 5 in this area to be here, and again in the Z axis you can make another array in Y will be 4, and you want 4 count. So let's again, so now we have made temple of this using some easy steps. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next tutorial.